हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ईसे एकेडमी। इन दिस लेक्चर लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड इमेज स्मूथनिंग एंड शार्पनिंग यूजिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी डोमेन फिल्टर्स। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी अंडरस्टूड अबाउट द फ्रीक्वेंसी डोमेन फिल्टर्स, वेयर द फिल्टर्स इन फ्रीक्वेंसी डोमेन रिमूव्स द हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी और लो फ्रीक्वेंसी कॉम्पोनेंट इन एन इमेज। Also, we understood that filters in frequency domain can be classified into two types. First one is low pass filter and second one is high pass filter. Low pass filter removes the high frequency component and retains the low frequency component. The application of low pass filter is to smoothen the image. For image smoothening, low pass filter is used in frequency domain. High pass filter removes the low frequency components and retains the high frequency component. High pass filter in frequency domain is used to sharpen the image. So high pass filter in frequency domain is used for image sharpening. These two filters can be classified it into three types. First type is ideal filter, second type is Butterworth filter, and third type is Gaussian filter. The first type of low pass filter in frequency domain is ideal low pass filter. The transformation function of ideal low pass filter can be written as h of u comma v is equal to 1 for d of u comma v is less than or equal to d naught, and it will be equal to 0 for d of u comma v is greater than d naught. Here d naught is non-negative quantity and d of u comma v is distance from points u comma v. So d naught here represents the non-negative quantity or non-negative value, and d of u comma v is the distance between the points u and v. So these two are any random points in a image. If we consider the image f of x comma y of size m cross n, at that case we can write d of u comma v is equal to u minus m by 2 whole square plus v minus n by 2 whole square. So this is the equation for d of u comma v. Now if we consider a waveform, let us say this is the signal. On this signal, the threshold value which we are taking is d naught. So for this, the transformation function will be 1 for the signal value less than or equal to d naught, and it will be 0 for signal value greater than d naught. So here if you consider this waveform, the transfer function is 1 for the value less than d naught, and the transformation function will be 0 for the value above d naught, which means the high frequency components in this signal will be removed and only the low frequency components will be retained using ideal low pass filter. Ideal high pass filter transformation function can be written as h of u comma v is equal to 0 for d of u comma v is less than or equal to d naught, and it will be equal to 1 for d of u comma v greater than d naught. So the high pass filter transformation function will be 1 for the frequency above d naught, and for the lower frequency the transformation function is 0. The frequency below d naught, the transformation function will become 0. So the ideal high pass filter will pass only the high frequency component and it will remove the low frequency component. This is how the ideal low pass and high pass filter will work. The major disadvantage of ideal high pass filter and low pass filter is after processing we'll obtain the blurred edges. So we'll get the blurred edges after processing using low pass and high pass filter. If you get a blurred edges, which means if you take an image and we are having an object in an image, and if the edges are blurred, we can't differentiate between the object and the other data in an image. So this is one of the disadvantage of ideal low pass filter and high pass filter. The second type of low pass filter is Butterworth low pass filter. The transfer function can be written as h of u comma v is equal to 1 divided by 1 plus d of u comma v divided by d naught whole to the power of 2n. And Butterworth high pass filter transfer function can be given as h of u comma v is equal to 1 divided by 1 plus d naught divided by d of u comma v whole to the power of 2n. Here the value of n varies from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. As the n value increases, the Butterworth filter will act as the ideal filter. Hence, n value should be maintained low or less so that we can remove the blurring of edges and edges can be defined clearly. So the advantage of Butterworth filter in both low pass and high pass is useful in defining the edges in an image. So to overcome the disadvantage of ideal filter, we can go with the Butterworth filter. The next type of filters are Gaussian low pass filter and Gaussian high pass filter. The transfer function can be given as h of u comma v is equal to exponential to the power of minus d square u comma v divided by 2 d naught square. For high pass filter, we can define it as h of u comma v is equal to 1 minus exponential to the power of minus d square of u comma v divided by 2 d naught square. The advantage of Gaussian low pass filter is that it removes low frequency noise. And the advantage of Gaussian high pass filter is that it removes high frequency noise. So this is the advantage of Gaussian low pass filter and Gaussian high pass filter. So this is about the image smoothening and sharpening using frequency domain filters. Hope you have understood the topic. Thank you.